wanted to highlight everybody who loves them a copy of Flair magazine. It's quite simple. For all of you who didn't catch the deets that were going down in December, January and February, that issue is out. Get yourself a copy and find out trendy looks for 2019 in case you're trying to change your wardrobe. Then, you know, there's a lot of stuff in here. Gary Opoka dancing to her own beat. There's food recipes. There's cleaning stuff. There's party clothes. But hey, there's a lot of things. Get yourself a copy of the Flair magazine. And, you know,
it is indeed for her.
Okay. That aside, hi guys, my name is Cinefius One, and today is a Thursday. I haven't reviewed a music video in a minute, so I decided, why not? Let me review my very first videos of 2019. Let's get it. So, 2019, of course, every artist, I think, was cooking the entire December or months before that, and they wanted to release most of the music this year. So, yes, the music has started coming out, the videos have started coming out, and of course, come on, you know I have to do this. So we're going to start my very first video review of the day with Navio. Yes, people, yes. If you thought you were still singing Kwanjula's songs, guess what? He got something new up his sleeve. So yesterday I was actually talking to Flex the Paper. He is a rapper. And a couple of us were in the studio and we're talking about real MCs and sucker MCs. And we're trying to know where Navio is at right now in his career. Is he a real MC? Has he turned into a sucker MC? Or is he a real MC? Anyway, they sent me the song. I was like, let me just watch it and find out what time it is with the song. Now, the video was directed by Banai, Erinya Nangeria Nemate. So what Eriya Ariz? I don't know. All I know, it was Navio. He never uses regular people. So there's more piano on that because he pretty much gave it the beat and the sound. He's from Gambia, by the way. So this is not a national beat. No, he had to take a flight. No, he did take a flight, but hey, you get the drift. Anyway, Navio comes through. The song is called Numbers. And the very first thing I noticed when I started to watch the video, he decided to do it in black and white. He decided to do it in a rusty, rugged background because, I mean, duh. And I just want to commend Navio on trying to come back as an MC. I feel like after I listened to this song, I was like, there's still a little you in there. You know, it's not just Kwanjula vibes. He dropped a couple of bars. He had a few punchlines in there. But the video, though, I wanted to ask you, Navio, I thought those things were only left for CNN when they're advertising for rich survey handy, donate to the children. That's when they put up like a child with a fly around it, like a malnourished child. These were good kids. It looked like they were in a hood. They was just chilling. I mean, was this the best idea? Because I don't even understand Nonya's storyline where numbers 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 I don't know how it happens to coincide with the plot of the video. Now, of course, yes, the plot of the video reminds me of, yeah, it's hip hop, you know, you can use anything around you, it's the culture. I don't think I love this part of the culture. No, I did not. It's supposed to come off nice. I did not. But half of the time, those kids were staring blankly into the camera like, why are we here? Is he paying us or something? And you're doing your thing and there's just no vibe in the video around you. Like, you were the only person in the video who carried a vibe. Everybody else in the video was just like, Batu Sasura. And you could tell. And I honestly expected you to go all out. I want you to go all out, go all hard, because you told me this year you have very many projects. I hear there's an album, you know? And this song is off that album. I expect you, Navio, to now go hard or go home. You've given us enough Kwanjula vibes. Now it's time for you to come and reclaim that seat. If you have it, bring it. That's all I'm just going to say. I mean, hip hop has done lost everything. What do I think about his style? Yeah, it sounds like trap music. It's like what everybody's doing. I just wish all of you could stop following the American trend and keep it 100. Do your own thing. If you're going to be a real MC, be a real MC. Don't be a trap king MC. I'm just, But to be honest, though, the song is not bad. It's a good song. It's a good song if you don't have to watch the video. It's a good song if you don't have to watch the video. It's a good song if you do not mind trap music. And it's a good song if you just want to give Navio a second shot at this hip-hop thing. I have nothing against Navi. I actually have mad love, but this, eh. Eddie Kenzo, last year he shot a song. I think it was like him introducing one of his artists that he signed on to. What is the name of their label? No Talent? Sorry, no. Big Talent. We're still waiting to see Pia Pounds' Big Talent. But for now, he signed this guy onto his record label. It's called, he's called New York. Now, excuse a sister when I'm like, who? New York, really? New York? New York? You couldn't go for a country more in your reach, like Tanzania, Kenya, but you called yourself New York, okay. Anyway, title of the track, Twende Sasa. It was shot by 01 Media. That's, of course, Darlington. And what do I have to say about the video? First of all, in the true works of Eddie Kenzo, if he has to put his name to anything, just know it is always going to be Igzamic. It's an eye orgasm, always. There's way too much color in the video. I loved how much color was in the video, and that's beautiful because your eyes keep you glued. There's too much color passing around that was shot. Let's talk about the storyline. The storyline for the video, I feel for the first time Eddie Kenzo nailed that. Too good, because it's Twende Sasa in brackets, quotes. It's called Holiday. Now, I'm watching the video and I'm like, wow, this is nice. But my mind just couldn't seem to get out the fact that I think I've seen this video somewhere. Where have I seen this kind of video? I was watching and I was loving what I was watching. And yo, concept mad crazy. Camera angles, camera lighting, everything. When it comes to the video, to be honest, Jacoba Tumuwai, it is that the video did come out, right? Down to the colorful outfits, down to the... I'm not so sure why those wood dancers were there, but it was a good concept. Now, that is for the video. Storyline on point. Everything else with the video was on point. Now, let us talk about the audio. Jesus is the Lord. This is a song you can only and only and only watch in mute. What the hell were these two people saying? I mean, we already have issues understanding what Kenzo is always saying in his videos. Kati weyare semu New York, oluzungu na atu lagambu sirwa New York, oluzungu lwewe chebitazi ingerie munderi. What the hell were you saying? Okay, last year, Omwana Jules, now she's not calling herself Jules anymore. Omwana Jules last year dropped her very first single. Her very first single was Nkukuba Kocha. I remember I did a review for the video and I was like, you know what, it's promising. There's something there. You know, there's something there. Now, at the beginning of this year, which is just this week. Wait, how many weeks are we into that? Is this the second week? Can't keep track. It's 365 days of January. So yes, a couple of days back, she dropped her second single. Her second single was dropped audio and video. I was like pumped. I'm like, yay, let me check this out. Now the title of the track is Nesunga, in quotes or in brackets, Your Love. Ooh, child. I wish I had just listened to the audio before, because damn, she sounds so beautiful. She sounds so angelic. She sounds all those beautiful things. Like, for once, I'm finally seeing someone could easily take Irene Tale's spot. Someone could easily take Banabalaba Kadabako, nah, Tubagobe, Irene Namubiru, Juliana Kanyomozi, Abobo, nah, that whole lot. I'm finally seeing someone who could stand up to that. And it's so weird that Winnie Nwaje recently talked about this very girl, Jules. I was like, hey, so now Winnie Amanya by Yimba. Eh, she knows she keeps afloat with the competition. Anyway, video of the song, Nesunga, Your Love. Hey, I don't think I have much to say about this video. The audio though, St. Andrew came through. I want to big up St. Andrew on this audio. It came right through the right kind of way. It's more playful. It reminds me that Jules is still young. She still has that cockiness, that edge to her. And if you put her in a direction that doesn't make her sound like she's 500 years old, this was it. You mastered this one. Audio, video though. Ah, video. I expected more. I wanted more. But for a second single, the video will do. There was too much green, too much yellow, it was a little bit too basic for me. It was too basic. The girls dancing in a backyard, kind of already saw that in Kukuba Kochi. The red, the yellow background that the girls were dancing onto was a little bit of the highlight. I expected it to pop more, but it didn't. It really didn't. I love the fact that for the first time, I actually saw Jules comfortable in her own skin. And that's a good thing, because she's a chunky girl like me. I saw her comfortable in her old skin. If you ask me about storyline, there's certain songs that don't really need storylines, but I hoped it would have a storyline. Yeah, so for me, Nesunga by Omwana Jules, beautiful audio, beautiful song. It's a song I would listen to almost any time. And the words, the lyrical content was so beautiful. It was neatly stringed together. You know, it has all those edgy things about being Ugandan. She talks about Bobby Wine. She talks about the Madvani. She talks about so many things in the video. It's a beautiful song. Anyway, you see, I started off this video review with Navio, and I wanted to really, really, really review a hip-hop artist because we haven't been doing that in a while. And I heard you have some new tracks coming out. You have something coming up with King Saha. Can't wait. I pray this is the new you. I pray you're back. I pray this year he gives us a little bit more, music that is acceptable to us because we're used to you in a certain light. So you have something coming up with Navio, with King Saha. And then I heard you have something coming up with, what's his name? The Nigerian guy? They have a collab together. I'm pumped. Let's see. But all I can say is bring it. And bring it real hard. You either go hard or you go home. I'm just saying, Navio, send that music my way and let me put two and two together. When was the last time he actually sang for us something that we remembered him for? So this will be good. And King Saha is crazy when you put him on a sick hook. And if it's hip-hop and Saha, let me wait though. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I'll catch you again tomorrow when it's a Friday. Baby, are people still dubbing in 2019? Let me dub out. I'm out. Peace.